Haya nini katula barie no satata. Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, my lover, my friend, my possessor.
For your time, for your love, for your patience and your support. Wow. This is the day the Lord has made. Viewers, this is my message for Nigeria. My message for the nation Nigeria, my country. Yes, in my vision, I saw the whole country. When I mean the whole country, I mean the whole place being deserted. When I say deserted, I mean empty, billows of smoke in the atmosphere. From burnt cars, burnt this, and some dead bodies. I was asking the Lord, I said, God, what is this? Then the realm changed. After the realm changed, I saw an eye. Take note of my word, viewers. I saw an eye that was moving. This eye was moving, and all of a sudden, it stumbled on an evidence, something that was covered up at some point. Take note, that which was covered up was not physical. It was not physical at all. The Lord gave that eye an enablement to see beyond the ordinary. And it saw. Take note of this word, viewers. That eye saw an error, an accumulation of errors of people in power, These people discovered this eye has found out and tried to cover and tried to pull and tried to take down. But grace was given to the eye and it ascended and went high up in the sky. That eye became an eye in the sky. This brought about the knowledge of those accumulated errors. This is a vision. Take note. This brought about the knowledge of those accumulated errors of leaders. The Lord caused a stir. Take note. The Lord caused a stir in the hearts of the people. Then the people started stretching their hands to bring to book. They started stretching their hands to bring to book the people responsible for such errors. Take note. They stretched forth their hand to bring to book those people responsible for those errors. These people responsible for those errors did not want to own up. This was bloody. When I say bloody, this was terrible. Blood, fire, billows of smoke. Let me just go straight to the point here, viewers. The nation, Nigeria, is surrounded presently with different issues. When I say different issues, I mean there are so many issues bothering this government. When I say government, I mean a particular age group of these political leaders. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is a servant of God. I know you might not understand what I mean. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, is a servant of God. He is a Moses to his people, a deliverer, a man that has the heart that loves and cares so much. He loves his people. He loves his people. But this is what the Lord is saying. Starting from now, the first, the second, and the third, at the end of the third, you start seeing signs of what I am saying. Something bloody will happen that will cause this sect of political leaders to be brought to book. When I mean brought to book, it is going to be an all-round fight. These people don't want to retire, and these people don't want you to come to discover what they have done. These political leaders are going to be brought to book, but it is not going to come easily. They would fight with the military. They would oppose with their weapons. When I mean their weapons, we are talking of the people. This is a government that is supposed to be for the people. By the people, would now have problems with those people. And at that point, it will be a clash. An intervention will happen of the military. But after this conflict, because these people will have support from Biafra, from all these organizations that wanted to break away, after these political leaders have been brought to book, violently brought to book, many of them would not make it. This is coming. The Nigeria would not break up, because once these political leaders has been brought to the book, and all these corrupt leaders have been put in their place. This is a direct message. These people like Biafra and all these people that wanted to leave would come together. Peace comes with a price. Freedom comes with a price. These people will come together and sit to talk to bring about a lasting solution to the country called Nigeria. This is the dawn of a new Nigeria, a new political system. Take note, this is a movement of the youth. When you see an Igbo man as the president of the nation, you know that Nigeria is about to become better. Take note, this is a vision. Something would happen. A revelation of what these fathers have done will come to light. Errors of the fathers, these political leaders would not want to own up. They don't want to leave because of the fear of being brought to book. This will cause resistance. And we are talking about the people. This justice by the people is a type that has never been before. Why? Because of the opposition, the oppression, and the killing of this sect. This would even extend to the body of Christ. They would stretch forth their hand to touch some of God's anointed, but only the truly anointed one. Take note, only the truly anointed one. The Savior will come down to defend. Take note. Afterwards, Biafra and other people that want to leave will come together. What is the purpose of leaving when the cause of the problems have been detected and they have been brought to book? There's no need to leave. It's the reason the country will remain one. When you see an Igbo man as president of Nigeria, then you know something new is about to happen. You know it is a new dawn for the nation Nigeria. This is my message for my nation Nigeria. This is my message for the indigenous people of Biafra. God bless Mazi Nnamdi Kanu of the indigenous people of Biafra, their leader, a servant of God, a Moses. Nigeria will stand, but these people must leave the place. Thank you. It is our time.